This video explains what kind of data types are available in FDWin Pro 7 and why a variable syntax is useful to use. In the previous videos, we explained already what can be understood under variables and what can be understood under variable classes. In this video, we will have a closer look now to the term data type. Any variable which will be used in the project needs an according data type. Let's check the online help of FDWin Pro 7 to get an overview about available data types. The most frequently used data types are the elementary data types. We can see here that every data type is defined by its value range. For example, the bool data type can only have the value 0 or 1. But an integer data type has a wider value range, which can contain natural numbers from -32,768 up to 32,767. If the PLC programmer wants to make some bit operations in his program, he would need to use the word or double word data types. So, simply stated, data types define the value range and operations that can be done on the declared variables. Next step is, how can we declare variables with these data types in FDWin Pro 7? Let's come back to FDWin Pro 7 and let us declare some global variables with their respective data types. First, we define a variable name, for example, lamp. Because the data type is still missing, we see here the red marked circle. By opening the drop-down list, we can select from the available data types. In our case, it would be a Boolean data type. This is the way how we assign variables to data types in FDWin Pro 7. This assigning process can also be done more comfortably by using prefixes for the variable names. For example, let us declare a variable of data type integer. In that case, I need to use the prefix I followed by the variable name. As we can see here, using a prefix for a variable defines already the data type, so there is no need anymore to select the requested data type from the drop-down list. Prefixes for other data types are shown on the following slide and are recommended to use accordingly in the PLC program. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching and feel free to check out the other videos on our website. Panasonic.